lesson of Egypt. Melinda?
That's right, Tom and Shelley. On the heels of President Obama calling for an end to all the violence, one man who lives in Manchester spoke with us tonight and said he's afraid of the growing violence in his native Egypt, where hundreds of people have died this week because of the outrage.
As civil unrest continues in Egypt, the country is torn over President Mohamed Morsi's being forced out of office.
It will never be the same thing again.
Nabil Mageli is a dual citizen of both Egypt and the United States and has lived in New Hampshire for more than 30 years, but visits his native Egypt every year. He was saddened to find the death toll has risen to at least 600 people after Wednesday's upheaval.
It makes me more than nervous. It makes me sad because every blood is human blood and is precious, no matter who the victim is.
Mohamed Morsi was the country's first democratically elected president. Mageli says it's a historic moment for his country because this is the first time the voice of Egypt's people could be heard in electing their leader.
For the first time, people walked the streets and forced their views, removed the president. This is a big shift in history.
Today, President Obama said he is calling for protesters to continue on, but to do it without violence, though condemned the government crackdown.
We call on the Egyptian authorities to respect the universal rights of the people. We call on those who are protesting to do so peacefully.
Mageli says those that provoke violence will contribute to Egypt's demise.
We're talking about people who rally, pushing the country into a chaotic end, where there is no hope in the future.
Now, President Obama also said today that the United States is planning to cancel joint military exercises that were planned for next month. That's the latest from the newsroom tonight. Melinda Davenport, WMUR News 9.
A shooting in